I did the thing. The animator from my critically acclaimed video has finally been made public. It's called Reanimator. In the background you can see the demo project that I've made to showcase the basic functionalities. And I'm gonna go back to this demo in just a second, but first, if you don't know, Reanimator is my custom animator tailored specifically for traditional animation. Animation represented by a series of cells displayed one after the other. Unlike its built-in brother, instead of continuously interpolating and blending stuff, it just picks the next cell to display whenever it's necessary. For example, if your animations are made on twos, meaning 12 frames per second, Reanimator will pick the next cell every 83 milliseconds. Conceptually, it just builds the final animation as it goes. But what may be more interesting to some people is that it's not modeled using a finite state machine, but rather a tree-like graph, which mitigates the quote-unquote transition hell problem. The point that I need to emphasize is that I've never said that, and I'm still not saying that this solution is better. I think it's a ridiculously weird concept, as you'll see in just a second, and it should be treated as an alternative, not as the next animator. Also, the whole thing is still in preview and it's more of my side project rather than something that I'm actively working on. Nevertheless, it works great for assertion, maybe it will work great for you. So if you are interested in trying it, the link's in the description. It's currently distributed as a package, so you just copy this link and then in the package manager you choose add package from git URL. And here it is. As I said, it's still in preview, so maybe don't migrate your entire project immediately. But if you're working on some prototype or maybe participating in a game jam, I'd be more than grateful if you'd like to try it out. Now let's get back to this demo. If you follow me on Twitter, you know that you can play it on my itch.io page. The whole project is also available on my GitHub, so you can take a look at the files yourself. It's a really simple classical platformer where we can jump, double jump, dash, and get hit by spikes, obviously. The important stuff is here, in the Jeff folder. Let's take a look at the controller. Not gonna lie, it's a chunky boy. It has almost 300 lines. I'd normally consider splitting it up, but it's not really the point of this demo. Anyway, starting from the top we have some configuration. Then we expose some useful data about the player, like which direction are they facing? Are they grounded? We do some physics calculations, and finally we have a really simple state pattern here, implemented using an enum. Our player can be in three possible states: movement, attack, and hit. Please note that these states have nothing to do with animations, they help me model the gameplay and make sure that the player cannot do something they're not supposed to. For example, when dashing, the gravity stops affecting you, you cannot jump, you cannot move, and you regain control only when the dash has ended. When you're being hit, you also lose control. You enter a sort of a ragdoll state, which you leave upon hitting the ground. If you don't know what the state pattern is or why it's useful in situations like this, I'd recommend the book Game Programming Patterns by Robert Nystrom. The web version is available for free and it's a really nice read. Moving on to what's important, the renderer. At the top here we have a class defining all the drivers that we are using. A driver is similar to a parameter in the built-in animator. Here we attach some event listeners. In the update method, we feed our reanimator the data from the controller. Some values are passed as they are, others require some mapping. And then at the bottom, we have our listeners. Okay, let's go back to the editor. As I said, each reanimator requires a tree-like graph made up of nodes. Once the time to display another cell has come, said reanimator asks its graph, "This is my current state. What should be the next cell?" This is called a resolution process. The state is basically a map of drivers with some integer values assigned to them. Unfortunately, there is no visual editor yet, so these nodes are created as separate scriptable objects. We can find all the available nodes here in the Reanimator menu. Let's take a look at the simple animation node. The most important thing here is the cells array. It contains cells, or frames, of the animation. We can fill it up manually, but it's much easier to just select our sprites and choose Simple Animation from Textures. Now for the sake of presentation, I'm gonna select Jeff, disable the renderer and assign this animation as the root for this reanimator. If I hit play, nothing happens. The graph is currently just this one animation, and the way this animation is resolved is that it checks the current state, looking for its control driver, and chooses the cell which has the same index as the value of this driver. As you can see, we haven't set up any name for this driver, so the animation will just use an auto-generated ID. But still, our state is empty, there are no drivers in here, so we just fall back to zero and choose the first cell. And if I do some rearranging, you can see that it's always the first cell being shown. In the past, to make this animation play, you had to do something like this. And I think you can already see what's happening here. Let me pause the game. Previously, idle was set to 1. Because of that, the graph chose the second cell, the cell with an index of 1. And the cell, when chosen, changed the next value of idle to 2. So the next time the graph is resolved, idle will be set to 2, and the third cell will be picked, continuing the cycle. Finally, we reach the last cell, which sets idle to 0, and the animation starts looping. Obviously, I'm showing you this just to explain how it works. Having to set this up for each animation would be silly. So let's remove idle from each cell, and instead I just check this auto-increment option, which under the hood does the exact same thing as we did a moment ago. This is the basis of how Reanimator works. We take the previous state, we feed it to the graph not only chooses the next cell, but it also influences how the next state will look like. And we can define how this next state is influenced using the drivers property. Notice that cells are not the only part of the graph that can modify the next state. The entire node can do that as well. You can also do that from code, using the set method. It's probably obvious, but only the nodes and frames that are chosen during the resolution process apply their changes to the next state. Another thing is that by default, drivers are kept in the state forever. If I remove this driver from here, for example, it's no longer being set by anything, but it's still present in our state. We can change that by marking a driver as temporary, and now it's only here if it's actively being set by something. It's worth mentioning that you can attach an event listener to any driver you want. For example, the run animation sets the step event driver whenever a character makes a step, which triggers a sound effect. The value doesn't matter here. If the driver has been set during the current resolution process, it will invoke its listeners. Moving on, another type of node is a switch. It works similarly to an animation node, but instead of cells, it chooses between a set of other nodes. So in our tree, these are the middle nodes, while animations are the leaves. We also have an override node, just like the animation override controller. It allows you to replace animations with other animations. In the demo, you can press H, which will activate an override and give you a hat. I haven't had the time to remake every animation, so it's just for the run, idle, and stopping. There are also mirrored animations. I use them in Astortion. They allow you to specify custom sprites for when the character is facing left. Currently, that's all the nodes. You can take a look at the Reanimator folder to see how they can be connected together. Lastly, let's analyze the transitional animations, because they're extremely weird. As you can see, when we land, there's this quick squash animation being played. The way it works is that when we're not moving, the ground switch, instead of choosing the idle animation, chooses this additional idle switch. This switch is controlled by a temporary driver called idle transition. When it's 0, it simply chooses the idle animation. When it's 1, the run to idle animation. When 2, jump to idle. Now if we take a look at the air switch, it sets the idle transition driver to 2. So if we are visiting our idle switch, and during the previous resolution process we did visit the air switch, the jump to idle animation will be chosen. And this animation is controlled by a temporary driver, which as the name suggests is also temporary, meaning that every time we switch to this animation, we will start at the first cell. This cell then sets the idle transition driver to 2, and this is because that driver is also temporary, so we need to keep sustaining it. It is only when we reach the last cell that we don't do that, and so it gets reset, and the idle switch reverts back to the idle animation. This is stupid. This is ridiculously overcomplicated. I know, listen, I'm not crazy. But this complexity can be covered. Another type of node can be created that will handle this for us. A node where you just specify an animation, transitional animations, and that's it. The rest is done automatically. But this is what I love about this project. It's a really simple set of rules that gives birth to a lot of interesting patterns. Another example, in Astortion, I synchronize the walk and run cycle by assigning them the same driver. I also use another driver to keep track of which leg is facing forward, and then, with a simple switch, I choose the correct idle animation. In this demo, falling animation sets the run driver to 2, so that when switching from falling to running, we start at the third cell. And it seems that the more time I spend playing with this thing, the more things I discover. Anyway, I know what you're thinking. You absolute hypocrite. You've said that Astortion is your main focus, and now you're dropping a video out of nowhere about some random resuscitator I don't even care about. See, the thing is, I took a week off to prepare for exams, and I was like, well, I've got some more free time. I've promised to release this animator. Might as well do that. I do wanna keep working on it though, we'll see how it goes. Still, the main focus? Astortion. So, thanks for watching, see you in the next video. It's gonna be a devlog. I know that for sure, cause I'm already working on it. It's gonna be about saving. Okay, bye.